Hello friends, my name is Nisha and welcome to my channel. This channel I have created to help civil engineering students to clear the various competitive exams like engineering service exam, GATE, PSC, PSUs, RRB, SSC, etc. So if you are preparing any of these exams, please do subscribe to my channel and keep watching. So let's start today's session. In today's session, we will discuss a basic topic on dynamics, engineering mechanics, that is linear motion. Let's consider an example of a train moving on a railway track. It's moving in a straight line, right? Say a car moving on a road, it's moving on a straight line. If I toss a coin upward, it takes a vertical straight line and reaches the maximum height and then comes down in a straight line. All these particles are, these bodies are moving in a straight line. Okay, so a particle moving in a straight line is known as a linear motion. Particle moving in a straight line is known as a linear motion. And these are the examples: train, railway track, train in a railway track, car moving in a road, coin tossed vertically upward. All these are examples for a linear motion. And then there are certain terms associated with this. Let's discuss one by one. First one is velocity. Velocity, you know. Before that velocity, I'll tell you. So this is a point A and this is a point B. And so this is the shortest distance between A and B. I'll represent it as S. That is a displacement between A and B. But I can take a path like this, and then reach B. So this path is the distance traveled to reach from A to B. This is the distance traveled, but this is the displacement. A to B, the shortest distance between A to B is the displacement, that is denoted by S. And then our velocity is equal. Velocity is the rate of change of displacement. Rate of change of displacement, and that is S by T. S by T. And the unit is, S is the displacement, the unit is meter, and T is the second time, unit is S. So meter per second is the unit of velocity. Mathematically, we can represent it as V is equal to ds by dt. Ds by dt. This is velocity. And acceleration is change of rate of change of velocity. Acceleration A is equal to rate of change of velocity. So V by t. Velocity by time, and then velocity we know, unit is meter per second, and then by time. So unit is meter per second square. Meter per second square. And then, one second. Meter per second square. Now, mathematically we can represent this as dv by dt, that is, we know it is ds by dt. So this is d by dt of ds by dt, or we can represent this as d square s by dt square. That is acceleration, velocity and acceleration. Okay, and then there are certain other notations which are important. I'll tell you what is it. Initial velocity is represented by u. When a train starts from a station, its initial velocity, all these velocities are represented by u. Final velocity is represented by v. T is the time taken, and s is the distance or displacement, and then a is acceleration. Okay, these are the notations in this linear motion. These are you must know. And then now there are certain equations, basic equations which you have to know. They are fundamental equations in linear motion. So they are two equations to find out the final velocity, equation to find out the distance traveled, and then relationship between velocity, acceleration and distance traveled. I'll derive all those things one by one so that the concept will be clear to you. To find out the final velocity, let's see. Acceleration is velocity, rate of change of velocity. We know A is equal to rate of change of velocity, but this V is it's the change in velocity. Change in velocity by T. So change in velocity is final velocity minus initial velocity is a change in velocity. So this can be represented by final velocity minus initial velocity, because v is the final velocity and u is the initial velocity, by t. Then, so a is, this is equal to a. Rewriting, a t is equal to v minus u. Again, rewriting, v is equal to u plus a t. This is the first equation. V equals final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus a t. V equal u plus a t. This is the first fundamental equation in linear motion. The second one is to find out distance traveled. We know how is it the distance traveled. Okay, we know again velocity is equal to s by t, distance, rate of change of displacement. This, so we can write this s is equal to v into t. Okay, now again we'll case, take the case of the train. So train, when it starts from a station, it will have very low velocity. Slow, it will start slow and then it accelerates, it gains speed and then it reaches to station B. So which is the velocity of the train? We cannot take the, we cannot say that from the A, the velocity is the train which starts from A or reaches B. No, we cannot say that. So we'll take the average velocity. Average velocity from A to B is the velocity. So here average velocity is initial velocity plus final velocity by 2. So this is equal to u plus v by 2 into t. But v, the final velocity, we know, we have found out another equation for it, v, that is u plus a t. Substituting that value here, u plus a t by 2 into t. This is equal to 2u plus a t by 2 into t. Solving, this is equal to, so this is s, s is equal to 2 by 2 u into t, t plus half a t t, a t square. So s is equal to u t plus half a t square. S equal to ut plus half at square. That is our second equation. Okay, second equation. And next one is the relation. In any case, if the t is not given, the time of travel is not given, and you are asked to find out velocity or distance or anything, acceleration or anything, you can use this equation. This is, in this equation there is no t, only v, u, a and s. How to find out this is also same like this. What we will do is, you know, we will find out the in this equation we will find out the value of t from this. Here v is equal to u plus a t, v minus u equal to a t, t is equal to v minus u by a. Substitute this value of t in this equation, so we will get u into v minus u, s is equal to by a plus half a into t square. Again v minus u by a the whole square. Solving and rearranging, we will get v square minus u square equal to 2as. That is our third equation. Okay, v square minus u square equal to 2as. These three are the fundamental equations in linear motion. You have to be thorough with this, and all the problems throughout dynamics you will be using these equations. Okay, now let us do a problem, solve a problem in this with this equation, so the concept will be clear to you. The question I have written here, I'll read out the question. A car is moving with a velocity of 15 meter per second and the car is brought to rest by applying brakes in 5 seconds. Determine the retardation and the distance traveled by the car after applying the brakes. Okay, so in this question we will apply these equations and find out the values. Before that, you have to be clear with certain concepts. I'll tell you, when a particle starts from rest, a particle starts from rest means it is in a stationary position and it starts moving. So the initial velocity, because the particle was initially rest, so the initial velocity when it start, when if I say the particle has starts from rest, the initial velocity will be 0. Starts from rest, initial velocity will be 0. Similarly, when a particle is brought to rest, means a particle was traveling and then suddenly it has brought to rest, then there is no movement, brought to rest. So the final velocity will be 0. If the particle starts from rest, initial velocity is 0, final particle brought to rest, final velocity will be 0. Then when a particle is projected upward, when a particle is projected upward, it will reach a maximum height. When it reaches the maximum height, it stops and then it comes down, right? So when it reaches the maximum height, the final velocity, when it projected upward, it reaches the maximum height and the final velocity will be 0. When it goes up, it reaches the maximum height and it stops. So the final velocity is 0 in the upward motion, upward straight line. But from the downward straight line, from there it comes, starts coming down. So from rest it starts, because when it reaches the maximum velocity it stops and then it starts from rest. So second portion, that is while coming down, the initial velocity is 0. Okay, when a particle is projected upward, it reaches the maximum height and it stops, so the final velocity is 0. But the same particle when it comes down, the initial velocity is 0. These concepts should be clear. Okay, now let's see this question. In this question, it is mentioned that a car is moving with a velocity 15 meter per second. So moving with a velocity is u is equal to 15 meter per second. And the car is brought to rest. It was moving with a velocity 15 meter per second, but it was brought to rest. So the final velocity is equal to 0. And by applying a brake in 5 seconds, that is t is equal to 5 seconds, and you are asked to find out the retardation. We have u, v and t, you are asked to find out the acceleration retardation. So applying in the equation, we get v equal to 0 is equal to 15 plus a into 5. Solving, we will get a is equal to minus 3 meter per second square. A is acceleration, this is so minus. So this is minus a. Minus 3 means retardation. Acceleration value is positive. Acceleration means gaining speed. It's positive. But retardation means coming to rest. So it is retardation. So retardation will be always minus value. Minus acceleration is known as retardation. So in multiple choice questions, if you are asked to find the acceleration, the value is minus 3. But if you are asked to find out the retardation, the value is 3. Minus acceleration is retardation. Okay, so acceleration is minus 3 and here it is asked for retardation. So retardation is 3 meter per second square. Okay, now then second part of the question is distance traveled by the car after brake is applied. So this equation, S is equal to u is initial velocity, that is 15 meter per second, t is 5, plus half into acceleration. Retardation was 3 and acceleration was minus 3. So here it is minus 3 into t square. T is 5 square. Solving, we will get a 37.5 meter. That is distance traveled by the car after applying brake. Okay. I hope this topic is clear to you. If you have any questions or queries or anything, you can comment in the comment section below. That's all for today. All the best for you. Thanks for watching.